there, friends. It's Nina. Thanks so much for joining me today for another video, and we're going to be getting colorful today. I love using alcohol inks, and especially when I pair them with lift ink, it creates a magical touch to your cards. I'm going to be pairing both alcohol inks and lift ink with these Gina K Designs stamp sets. These stamps have great solid images, which would be perfect for using with this lift ink technique. I'm going to be using the flowers from the Better Together set and the sentiments from Just Add Color. Here is our alcohol lift ink pad. If you've never used one of these before, I definitely recommend having also the alcohol lift ink refill. I like making sure that my ink pad is nice and juicy when I use this technique because having a juicy ink pad is going to provide the best stamping results when you're stamping with the lift ink. Lift ink is basically like stamping with blending solution. If you think about when you use alcohol inks with blending solution, it moves the color and it pushes it. In this case, when you stamp with it, you're going to lift off that color and it's going to create a lighter version of the color underneath, or it's going to be almost white. It depends on how it reacts with the alcohol ink. So I have some alcohol inks and blending solution here, and I'm also going to use an air blower. Now this happens to be from We Are Memory Keepers. I don't have the Tim Holtz one right now, but the We Are Memory Keepers is the one I'm using today. I'm going to start by taking a piece of Simon Says Stamp alcohol ink paper and some blending solution. I'm going to squirt a bunch of that onto the paper. I like to start with blending solution because it helps move the alcohol inks initially as we put them on the paper. And then I'm just going to start picking out some alcohol inks and adding them down onto my paper. I'm going rainbow order for this particular color combination, but you don't have to go rainbow colors. You could do whatever color combination you want. This technique looks amazing with no matter what types of colors you create with. I'm going to go ahead and blow these inks around, moving them across my paper to not only mix the colors, but to also create some beautiful patterns. I love when alcohol inks dry and create some unique spots of color. Don't forget, you can always add more layers to your alcohol ink backgrounds. I love adding more blending solution to move the color around. I also love adding more color in general. It really creates some nice layers. And you just want to play around with it until you're happy. Now also don't forget that you don't have to overwork this paper. I encourage you to oftentimes stop and let the paper dry before coming in with another layer because you may love how it turns out after it dries. While alcohol inks dry, they create a whole new look from when you started with them. Now I went mostly rainbow colors for my finished cards today, but I did want to show you another color combination that was really fun. I'm going to save this for another project. For this one, I used purple, green, pink, and a little bit of like an orangey yellow. These mixed together and created totally unique looks for my background. Now, another fun technique that I love doing with alcohol inks is splatters. I'm using the Tim Holtz alcohol ink splatter brush, and I'm going to drip a little bit of alcohol blending solution onto my brush and then splatter this across my paper. The effect is so cool. I'm going to do this again on the rainbow background that I have here. So again, I'll just drip some of that blending solution onto my brush and then carefully splatter it across my paper. Check out how magical this looks. It's so amazing. Now, I find the best splatter results are when you let the paper dry a little bit before going totally onto wet paper. It creates a much more intense splatter. But if you want something a little more softer, definitely go ahead while the ink is still wet. Our papers are dry at this point, and we want to go ahead and start stamping on them with the lift ink. I have my flower from the Better Together stamp set in my Misty, and I'm stamping it onto a corner of the paper with some lift ink. I'm going to then rotate the paper and stamp it again, making sure that I clean my stamp in between each stamping because I don't want to transfer any alcohol that's lifted off of my paper onto the next stamping. So now that I have this panel stamped, I'll move on to stamping the next panel. Again, we'll do the same process, but this time I did put the positioning of the stamp in more of an arc instead of in the corner, just for a little bit of something different. Once we stamp both sides of our paper, again, making sure to clean in between each stamp, we can now work on lifting the rest of the color off of these, because you'll notice that it hasn't totally lifted the flower design off of this paper. What I like to do is I take a soft cloth, in this case it's a microfiber cloth, and I'm going to go ahead and carefully brush over top of any of the inked areas with my cloth. I'm removing what's left of the ink that's on the paper and is revealing our beautiful florals on the pattern. I just love this technique because every time I do this, it's completely different. Sometimes you're going to get more of an artsy look and it's not going to be totally defined, and other times it's really, really crisp and clear like this one. It all depends on how the ink reacts with the alcohol inks underneath. I think this is a really fun and unique way to add some texture and some uniqueness to your alcohol inking. So I did this to all of the backgrounds that I made today. And now we're going to go ahead and work on turning these into beautiful cards. I'm going to pull out a foil plate from Spellbinders. This happens to be a dot rectangle, but there are many different types of rectangle borders that you could use for this project, not just the dots. And I have them all linked in the video description below, as well as all the other products that I'm using today. So definitely be sure to check that out. I'm heating up this foil plate inside of my Gemini foil press machine. Any foil press machine that you have, you'll be able to do this technique with. After heating it up and running this through my die cut machine to press the plate and the foil into my paper, we're left with this gorgeous foil design. I also wanted to mention, when I'm cutting my foil, I find this tool from Spellbinders super helpful. This is a quick cutter from Spellbinders. It comes with little blades that are perfect for cutting your foils with, and it has a ruler to help keep you guided as you cut. And it saves you from having to wrinkle any of your foils. Foils are very delicate, so I like being able to have a tool like this to help me keep my foil in place as I'm cutting and not have to worry about any crinkles. So I'm continuing to foil my backgrounds with this dot pattern. If you've never foiled before, definitely be sure to check out the video that I have linked in the top right corner. This is a much more in-depth process of how to foil with plates like this. It's really simple and easy to do, and it provides amazing results on your card projects. Now that I have my backgrounds foiled with the border, I'm going to bring in some vellum and that same Better Together floral stamp, and we're going to stamp this onto vellum. I'm stamping with embossing ink. My plan is to stamp this flower with embossing ink that matches the foil that I used on my projects. I used both silver and gold foil when I was foiling those borders on my backgrounds. So I'm going to stamp flowers for each of these cards with both silver and gold embossing powder. My plan is to use one sprig of florals behind my sentiment. I'll show you what I mean in a minute here. I'm carefully heat setting my embossing powder with my heat tool, making sure that my heat tool is really hot before putting it up against my paper so that I don't warp the vellum. Here's where we're going to work on our sentiment. I have a nested oval die from Simon Says Stamp, and I'm going to die cut this from Soft Navy cardstock. Once I've die cut this oval shape from not only Soft Navy, but other colors of cardstock that match the colors in my projects, I'm going to work on layering these with the flowers and stamping a sentiment on top. My sentiment is from that Just Add Color stamp set, and I'm going to stamp this with embossing ink as well. My plan is to match the embossing that I do for the sentiment with the flower and also the foil on each card. So every card that has silver foil, for instance, is going to have silver embossed flowers and silver embossed sentiment. And of course, I'll repeat the same thing for anything that's gold. I love how this looks. It creates a beautiful layer on top of our very artsy florals on the background. Adding this defined layer of florals behind the sentiment really draws everything together. So our finished cards are going to look like this. Our last step is to add some sequins. I have some solid quartz sequins from Gina K Designs that I'm gluing down onto my card using glossy accents. These are beautiful clear sequins, no holes on them, so they have a really nice, gorgeous finish. And I love how these add just a little bit more extra sparkle to my finished cards. The colors on these cards are just stunning. You never know how a project is going to turn out when you're using alcohol inks because they're so unexpected and they create such amazing results. I love working with them, and I loved pairing this technique with the Gina K Designs Better Together and Just Add Color stamp sets to create these really pretty one-of-a-kind cards. I hope you enjoyed today's project and that you were inspired to try this alcohol lifting technique with either these stamps or maybe stamps that you already have in your stash. I thank you so much for stopping by and watching this video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you will also stay tuned and watch some of the videos that we have on screen for you. Don't forget that you can also subscribe to stay up to date on all of our future videos, and I will be back very soon with more to share. Until next time, I hope you all have a very wonderful day. Bye!